options is lip reduction. I think it sounds a little crazy to the majority of you out there, but if you're watching this video, you probably are interested in it. You know, what we see in the West is we want to make lips bigger. But unfortunately, sometimes that becomes overzealous, and then you get a lip that's ridiculously too large, or it's lumpy, or it doesn't look right. This gentleman who's been nice enough to let us film him is a gentleman that had silicone performed probably not by a physician, I would assume, or at least not a licensed practitioner. Now, I perform silicone all the time, believe it or not, but I use it for acne scars, and I believe in that context is very safe. Unfortunately, silicone that's done elsewhere, they're using large globs and placed in the lips, it's not a good combination. I probably fix one of those every week. I divide my time between fixing permanent lip issues, most likely silicone, but also fat, bioalkamid, bioplastique, Artifil, Artical, Radius, you name it, I've taken it out of a lip, Alloderm, the list goes on. But most commonly, it's silicone. The other indication for lip reduction is an ethnic lip. Someone that has an ethnic doesn't have to necessarily mean African American. It can be Hispanic, it can be Asian, and even white. So it's basically someone born with a very large lip. Other indications are less common that I do perform that as well is for scarring, people with traumatic lips, people with cleft lip issues, although I'm not performing cleft lips. It's just some byproduct of having some kind of congenital issues, vascular malformations. I just did a lady with a hemangioma reduction about a month ago. So these are just different indications to reduce lips. What I'm reducing is the red portion of the lip. I encourage you to watch my video on the lip reduction virtual consultation for greater details. This will not be a redundant video about that. I just wanted to preface this comment here. So this is really just talking about what I did for this gentleman who's kind enough to be filmed. We're actually doing a touch-up procedure. This is a year ago almost that we did the first procedure, and there was still a little something left, and this is the thing that's true about silicone lips, is that 95% of my patients I do once. 5%, I get a huge reduction, a good improvement, but then there's that little bit left that just didn't quite make it. So for him, if you see these vertical incisions, the initial concern is with vertical incisions coming down that that's not going to heal well, but we all have these little line corrugations there. And one thing my mentor always taught me is that a line is almost always worth trading off for a contour problem. A contour problem is like a ball or a divot, something like that. And he had two little balls that were just left over from the surgery, had a tiny one inside his mouth as well that I addressed. So first, I'm cutting along a line that's a natural line, but in addition to that, it's also a line that needs to be done to get the best result. And so a lot of people try with lip reductions to go 6 miles away from the problem, go inside, dig around, grab it, close it. It's inaccurate. And so where I really believe is the shortest distance to the problem is the trick. So if there's a bump there, I go to the bump. I don't go over here to try to hide a scar because the scars heal well. You can't even see a scar. It's about a year out. Open your mouth. Look at this. It looks really good. You can't even tell that he's had a lip reduction. Now, show them. Let's get your phone out. Do you have your phone?
Mm-hmm.
I want to show you where he started. And you can show the phone. And this is what's really cool is take a look at this. See if you can see that. You can show all the scary photos if you want. Sure. Whatever you got.
Yeah.
Take a look at that. Can that show up on there, Denny? Can you see it? So you can see how bizarre that looks, okay? And this is where he started. So today he's already 10 miles into awesome, but this is a correction where he got 98% of the correction already a year ago, right after that, the first one. So big difference. You can already see he's natural looking. Oh. That's a little bit too sexy there.
Yeah.
We gotta edit that out. Just joking, guys. There's a sexy guy. What do you want? He's got to have sexy lips with a sexy body. He's got to match. So you can see that transformation. So my big passion is to help people that have these deformities. No pain, right?
None whatsoever.
So I'm really good with dental blocks. It's not just, he's not being paid. There's not a paid testimonials. There are no paid testimonials on my website at all. These are real people that have real problems that have come into me to get this fixed. So this was a good small correction for him. A byproduct of this, he's actually gotten a fuller lip. So he actually looks even sexier with a full lip, but a natural one, not one that looks deformed. And so he's a damn good looking guy. And so the terrible thing is to live with such a deformity, right? Mm-hmm. That just mars his attractiveness. Now, that's it. Good, thank you guys.